got laws about murder. God got laws about stealing. And we got all these churches set up in our neighborhood, yet they won't teach the law. And we want to know why the crime rate's so high in our neighborhood.
Bring it up.
They ain't teaching you what you need to know. Let's read what you got.
Leviticus chapter 26, verse 14. But if ye will not hearken unto me.
So first he told us if we hearken, we're going to be a very blessed people set above all nations. But he said we will not hearken, read.
And will not do all these commandments.
Hold on, some of these commandments.
And will not do all these commandments.
Read.
And if ye shall despise my statutes.
He said we despise this statute. Man, our people despise the law. Man, it's the Sabbath day right now. The church is buying, selling, and cooking on the Sabbath day.
Bring it
if
up.
It was Sunday, guess what they going to do? They going to buy and sell and cook on Sunday if it's the Sabbath day. That they supposed to be holy, sacred above all other days. But yes,
right.
We continue to break these laws. Read.
Or if your soul abhor my judgment.
Read.
So that ye will not do all my commandments.
So the Most High said we'll do all his commandments. Read.
But that ye break my covenant.
He said we break his covenant. You know what I want.
Verse 17.
Read.
And I will set my face against you.
The Most High God said, brother, we break his covenant. Guess what he going to do? He going to set his face against us. If I set my face against you right now, if I ask you to do something, and you don't do it, if I set my face against you, you think it's going to be pretty? No, it ain't going to be pretty. It's the same way with the Most High God.
That's right.
We made an agreement to do something. And for not doing it, he set his face against us. The Most High God is against us right now. Why do you think all this evil is happening to us in our community? A lot of people say, I don't agree. They say God with them, but God ain't with them. God ain't with our people. Look at the disaster, and look at how people carry themselves in our neighborhood. But we think God with us. You at the bottom of society. You go to another nation of people for food, wine, and clothes. God with you though. Read what you got.
And I will set my face against you.
So for breaking the covenant, young brother. For breaking the covenant, young sister. He said, I'm going to set my face against you. Read.
And ye shall be slain before your enemies.
He said, you're going to be slain before your enemies. I want you to know, I'm going to tell you to do something tonight. Go to the house and Google lynch. And when you Google lynch, you know what you're going to see? You're going to see a bunch of white people around taking a pose like this. Everybody posing, pointing while you hanging. God said, what?
And I will set my face against you.
This is the reason why it's happening. He said, I'm going to set my face against you. Read.
And ye shall be slain before your enemies.
He said, you're going to be slain before your enemies if you don't keep this covenant that I made with you.
Right.
If you break this promise that I made with you.
Bring
he
it
said,
out.
You're going to be slain before your enemies. Read. You're the ones being slain before your enemies. Look what just happened to Kajin Powell. Look what happened to Trayvon Martin. Look what happened to, give me some, Sean Bell, Mike Brown. Look what they were slain before they hit me. And we kill each other every day, but you know the difference between when we kill each other, you go to jail, you pay for it. They kill you, they walk free and act like nothing don't happen.
Yes,
you
right.
Pay for your crime, because God ain't going to let you get away with his crime, because he testing who he loves. Read what you got.
They that hate you.
God said they that hate you, not the people that love you. He said what?
They that hate you.
He said, they that hate you for breaking his laws, statutes, and commandments, for breaking his covenant. He said, what?
They that hate you.
The people that hate you, we
shall reign over you.
Shall reign over. Who ruling over you? Who ruling over you? You want to know why they ruling over you? Because you broke the commandment. Deuteronomy 28, verse 32.
Bring it up. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 28, verse 32.
Now look, our condition, everything the black man going through right now is in the belt. And for breaking the law, statutes, and commandments, we went into slavery. Slavery is prophesied in the Bible.
Right.
Slavery is Bible prophecy.
Right.
This ain't no religion. This ain't no Christianity. This your husband.
Right.
These your customs.
Right.
These your laws. These your traditions.
That's
read
right.
What you got, bro.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 32.
Read, bro.
Thy sons and thy daughters.
He said, thy sons and thy daughters, read.
Shall be given unto another people.
Shall be given unto another people. Now, these brothers said these ain't our traditions. But yeah, I'm going to show you what traditions we don't hold. Mark 7 and 6.
No, bring it up in the Bible.
This is our tradition. Give me the encyclopedia world. Read what I got. These are traditions that
child
uphold. Read.
Mark chapter 7, verse 6.
Read.
No,
he asked
him
to
send him.
Well,
Isaiah prophesied of you hypocrites.
He said, what? Isaiah prophesied of you hypocrites. Read.
As it is written.
As it what?
As it is written.
Read.
This people honor me with their lips.
A lot of people say they love the law, they love God.
They hold it, Bob. That's said, written by the white man.
Honor me with their lips, we.
Slaves should come Jesus, man. They're not going to leave that
at God. Their heart is far from me, we.
Help me in vain do they worship me.
He said, help me in vain do
they
worship me.
How
people worshiping the earth most high in vain, we.
Teachers for doctrine.
Before that.
The commandments of men.
Give me that blue book on top. He said, teaching for doctrine is the commandments of men. What our people teach is what they learn from man. What we teach is what the Holy Spirit has revealed to us. Read on.
That's right.
For laying aside the commandment of God.
Just like brothers like this, and a lot of our people down here, they lay aside the commandments of God.
Ye hold the tradition of men.
They lay aside the commandments of God to uphold the traditions of men. This is the tradition of men right here. Read.
As the washing of pots and cups.
The same way they hold the tradition of washing pots and cups. Just like this. Who you think taught us to dress the way we dress? Our same as it did, but God told us to do this. This is our tradition. You lay aside the commandments of God to uphold the tradition of men.
Ain't gonna give you no good job.
And many other such like things ye do.
Okay, now look.
No, man.
All right, let me see that. Now, first of all, let me show y'all something.
It's all written
the brother said King James was a white man. Let's rule that.
But he was homosexual.
This is a book written by King James. Come here, come closer, bro. Let me show y'all that King James was a black man.
That's right.
See, look, as people come up and see they uphold the traditions of men. Drinking that beer on TSU, homecoming on the Lord's Sabbath day, that's upholding the tradition of men.
That's right.
Who is that? What color is he?
Black.
He's a black man.
That's right.
Now look, hold on. He said King James was a homosexual. Get your page, Colin, and read. Get your page, Colin, and read.
That's right.
It ain't it. It's another book. King James wrote a letter to his son, telling his son, look, it's things that you ought not to be forgiven for. And homosexual attitude was one of them.
So
prove that King James ain't no white man. First, give me Psalm 68, verse 11. Now let me show you who Bible this is. Because everybody say the white man gave you this book.
Read it out.
Say the white man book.
Smart.
Which one is that?
Read what you got, bro.
Which one is that?
Hold on, read this verse. Psalm 68 and 11.
The book of Psalms, chapter 68, verse 11.
Read what you got.
The Lord gave the word.
God gave his word.
That's right.
Read.
Great was the company of those that published
it. Even though King James black, you said great, but we don't care about King James. We care about the word of God. Let me show you what book this is. Every day highlighted, bro. Read.
The most significant of the small nations for the history of Western civilization was that of the Hebrews.
Is the white man Hebrews?
No.
It said this is the most significant of the Western history of civilization. Hebrews.
We are aided in telling their story.
This is how they tell the story of the Hebrews, read.
By a magnificent literary record.
All this is your magnificent literary record. Nobody can contend with us in history. That's why when the brother got said, things about King James, things about the Bible, what I do, I get to show you the history.
That's
nobody can contend. This outlet, we put this literary record together.
That's right.
Here's what you got.
They created their Bible.
Hold on, what?
Bible.
The magnificent literary record of Hebrews is our Bible.
That's
who
called
it our Bible?
Called the Old Testament.
By who?
In the Christian
world. The white
man called
this the Old Testament in the New Testament. We didn't never called it that. This our Bible. These our literary records. The reason why it was given to us in English, why? Isaiah 28 and 11. Let me show you why we got this in English. So first, don't let nobody ever fool you and say, this the white man bow. According to the white man, he said this the Hebrews bow.
When
we tell they magnificent literary record with this right here, with their records. This your records. Now read what you got, bro.
Isaiah chapter 28, verse 11.
Now I know y'all like it. We Hebrew, why we got it in English? This is the prophecy, read.
For with stammering lips.
Now I said with stammering lips, read.
And another tongue.
Another tongue is a language. In another language, read.
Will he speak to this people?
He's speaking to you in English right now.
That's right.
God's speaking to you in English right now. That's a lot of people don't believe the prophets walk the earth. They don't believe that the men, I'm going to show you what the prophets were doing, the same thing we were doing. Nehemiah 9, verse 26. We can leave these alone. If anybody need any more history, we're going to go to history. We don't deal with nothing but knowledge out here.
That's right.
Everything we reading is going to come out of books. It ain't my own head. We coming with that.
You got me, bro.
All praise to the Most High. What's your name, bro?
Mike,
hey, and don't take my hostility for anger, bro. Now, we love our people, but we got to show them the truth, bro. We got to show them the truth, Mike. Read what you got.
Nehemiah chapter 9, verse 26.
Now, listen to this. Every time our people come out here and prophesy in the future, listen.
Nevertheless, they were disobedient. Verse 25. And they took strong cities.
Yes, 26.
Verse 26. Nevertheless, they were disobedient and rebelled against thee.
That's what our people are doing right now. This is supposed to be a land built up on Christianity, but yet the word of God coming out, all these people claiming to love Jesus walk back and forth across the past about.
That's right.
All the people that say they love God don't want to hear the word of God, but this land built up on Christianity.
Yes.
You know the majority of these people out here right now, Christians, even Islam worship Christ. Islam say they worship the Most High God, but yet when the Bible come out, you know what they do? They walk back and forth, man. The prophet said the same thing, read.
And cast thy law.
When the law come out, our people cast the law, what?
Behind their backs.
Our people don't want to hear the law. But what we out here to do to show you who you are. Let me see that sign.
Man, where y'all being,
man? Man, we be all over, man. We got some brothers up here, and I'm going to hook you up with some brothers up here if you're really sincere about learning.
All over.
But look, man, all over the U.S., all over the world. We everywhere. Now, let me show you something. The 12 tribes of Israel. You see your forefathers on this sign? The slave master gave us these names on the right hand side. God named you this on the left hand side.
Right. No, I want my kid to change his last name.
All praise him because he got the same. Let me show you something. God wants you to do the same thing. Isaiah 44:5. God wants you to do the same thing. He wants you to change your last name.
That's right.
For real. Matter of fact, he wants you to change your name. Period.
Right.
Isaiah chapter 44:5.
Read what you got.
One shall say, I am the Lord. And another shall call himself by the name of Jacob.
Read.
And another shall subscribe with his hands unto the Lord.
And do what?
And surname himself.
Surname yourself.
By the name of Israel.
That's, you know what Israel means? Israel means a prince that has power with God.
That's right.
That's what we out here doing, trying to teach our people, you God's chosen people.
That's right.
Slavery's in the Bible. It's Bible prophecy. That's why you had to get this. Notice, in 1611, he started requesting for this to be translated. 1619, the slave trade going full force. Why? Because God knew you going, he prophesied that you was going to be here in the land of your captivity. And I'm going to show you what we, before we go, what you need to do. To sit up here and turn this captivity. Give me Psalms 19, verse 6. Give me Acts 3, verse 19. So according to the Bible, you so-called African-Americans are from the tribe of Jews.
That's right.
You so-called Jamaicans is from the tribe of Benjamin.
That's right.
You so-called Haitians is from the tribe of...
Shalom, Israel. I'm Elder Nathaniel, Israel United in Christ. YouTube likes to shut our channels down, as some of you have noticed, ever so often. Subscribing to Join IUIC will assure you will always stay connected to our YouTube accounts. We want to do our best to make sure this truth gets out. Please click and join our subscriber YouTube channel called Join IUIC to stay linked to all of our videos. So again, please make sure you subscribe to this Join IUIC channel to get your latest updates on all our YouTube channels. Shalom.